Hey, Joelas, I wanted to give you this before I left to join the Union. My father gave it to me when he died, and I thought you should have it, just in case I don't make it back. I hope you use it to remind you of our family's past. It's a very special part of our family history.
Bye, Papa. Please come back.
I can't promise that, darling, but I'll try my hardest.
Okay. I wonder what this could be. Potato seeds. Where are these stupid things from? Maybe I'm missing something in my father's life. He and his father immigrated from Ireland to New York City during the potato famine of 1846. He got separated from his father during that process. Once in New York, he joined a gang that smuggled and sold potatoes illegally. It was illegal because of the famine going on in Ireland. While the famine, disease and plague swept across Ireland, and the Americans didn't want to have anything imported from Ireland. They didn't want to become contaminated from the food they imported from Ireland, foods like potatoes, so they made potatoes illegal. However, people still wanted potatoes, so the potato gangs were created under the rule of the infamous Potato War. These gangs were run for the sole purpose of smuggling and selling potatoes to different buyers. The streets of New York were tough to live on. People were poor, hungry, without jobs, and struggling to survive due to strikes in the workforce and factories. Hobos roamed the streets aimlessly.
Oh, looky here, another coin. That makes 27 cents today. I can almost buy myself a cheeseburger. Oh man, I'll be eating good tonight. Even better than when I still lived in the orphanage. I'm better off than those other hobos across the river, that's for sure. Oh, I hope I don't nearly forget where I put my stash like that last time in the Bronx. Oh, that's pretty good. Sure do hope those other hobo friends see this one. Oh, go assassin.
Well, you know, Seabass, there's normally richer people here in the Queens. I think this would be a great place to get some cash.
You know, I think you're right. But let's make sure to find someone who's dressed really nicely, though, this time. Remember what happened the last time?
True, true. Let's hope we only have to do this once. So here's a plan. We wait out in an alley until a nicely dressed woman comes by. Then we jump out and attack her and take all her money. Then we tell her if she tells anybody, we will not hesitate to knock her out. Sound good?
Good plan, X.
Let's get going. We only have 3 more hours till sunset.
Well, that was a close one. Sure do hope none of their gangsters don't get to me and Mustang.
Okay, so let's wait here until somebody walks by. Got that, Seabass?
Yeah, I sure do. I can't wait for this one. Oh, look, here comes a chance. Give me all your money. Give me everything you have. And put those earrings in the mix as well. See that money in your pocket? Give it here.
Please, don't do this. I have 4 children at home. This was the money I was going to pay for their education. Please.
Tell your child they can go teach themselves something good. We didn't get no education, and look how we turned out.
What? I can't understand anything you guys are saying.
Excuse me? It's rude to point out people's flaws.
You guys are muggers. Evil.
Who's trying to say that Weez is bad people? Now that is rude. Give me everything you have or I'll have to knock you out.
Fine. Please just don't hurt me. My children are depending on me. Here.
And don't you tell the cops either. They don't need to get into this mix here.
Wow, that was a lot tougher than I thought it was going to be. Now let's go use this money to buy some potatoes. This should be enough for 11.
Psst, over here.
Seabass, did you hear that?
Psst. Yeah, I did. Psst.
It must be a ghost. Ha!
Xavier, be quiet. That ain't no ghost.
It sounds like a lot like the potato lord.
Psst, over here. He must be somewhere around here. Remember the secret knock?
I've been waiting here for 15 seconds. I don't know if you guys want to make a deal.
Yeah, we got held up after acquiring the money. But we have, and we're ready to make the deal.
Where's your part of the deal, huh?
It's all in order, gentlemen. Both in here. If you get caught, you don't say anything about me. Got it?
Got it.
Oh, that's Seabass. I met him in the Irish gang for potatoes. We even roomed together.
That's nice. So you're finally getting back on your feet?
What? How did you know that?
You guys need to leave. Now.
X, you know, this is the first time anyone has ever called me a gentleman.
Yeah, me too, come to think of it. That is kind of strange, don't you think? While you were counting potatoes, we actually had a conversation. He knows something about me, and I don't know how.
Yeah, that does sound kind of weird. It's almost like there's some kind of a connection between you guys. Well, anyways, let's go find someone who wants to buy these taters. What'd you say?
Sounds great, Seabass. Do you have our money? You know how much potatoes take to grow these days, extra starch and all.
These are better be good because I'm taking a big risk dealing with you guys.
Oh, don't worry. We can promise that these are some of the best Irish potatoes ever. Almost too good to sell. Especially for this little money.
Got a point there, Seabass. What do you say we knock her out, take the potatoes, and sell them to someone else with more money?
Please, no.
Yeah, we can't bring back this little profit to the potato lord if we expect to get paid too. We have to make a living too, you know. Come on, X, we gotta get out of here before the cops come. I can't afford to get a cop. My sisters are depending on me.
Hold on one sec. We can't let her die like this.
True, true.
Okay, now we can leave. Here we go. Now's our chance. Let's get in and get out.
Roger that. Wow, this hobo is actually doing pretty good for himself. Well, sucks to be him.
Wait, this seems wrong. Are we seriously that mean as to rob from a hobo? Like, seriously, a hobo.
Oh, shut up and grab the money. It's a hobo. I don't even think they have rights.
I guess you're right. Let's just get out of here.
No good stealing gangsters gun and then stole my stash. I better go report them to you, Patties. They're in big trouble now.
Okay, it wasn't.
Sam, I really don't think that there's much I can do about this. We normally have to wait for two reports before we can do any investigating.
It's
I understand
fine.
That potato smugglers are a big deal in this New York area because of the potato famine, but I don't really think there's much we can do. Can you at least explain, Spider?
Yes. One was tall, dark hair, brown eyes, and the other was average height, light brown hair, blue eyes, and womanly features.
That will be very helpful if there's anyone in the report.
Officer! They don't deal with so mustache!
Who did?
They're no good for nothing, my potato gangsters.
There it is, the second report. We have to do something about this.
I think that we should surround them. Can you do some of that cap juju stuff?
No, that'll never work.
You know, that's actually a really good idea. So here's the thing.
Hurry up, Xavier, it's 3:59. Only one more minute.
Yeah, it's fine. Look, it's right here. Do you remember the secret knock?
Of course I do.
What took you so long? You're right on time.
That made no sense. Anyways, do you have 11 for us again?
This is enough for 10.
10? What do you mean 10? That's the same amount that we had last time, and we got 11 last time.
Prices went up. What can I say? Extra starch is not cheap.
Ugh, fine.
Thank you, sir.
What do you guys think you're up to?
We're playing a game of hide and go seek.
Outside in an alley? What's that smell? Are those potatoes?
No, those are, hamsters!
They don't even have fur.
They're, hairless hamsters.
Quit the ad. We gotcha. Those are potatoes, and that is very illegal.
I've got something to tell you.
What is it?
I am your father.
What? Father, you've been here the whole time?
Yes, son, I've been watching over you.
Why didn't you just tell me? I had to find my own family.
I'm sorry, son. I need you to take this.
Thank you, Father.
Son, I'm sorry.
No!
under the court for the process of dealing potatoes in a time of banishment, acquiring weapons, and assaulting an officer. They are also under the court for robbery and attempted murder to a middle-aged woman. Would anybody like to speak?
I would like to speak, please.
Come forward. You now have the court.
I was walking down the street on a beautiful afternoon when all of a sudden these two people mugged me and roughed me up. They took everything I had. They even gave me bruises on my sides.
Does that end your allegation?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Who is next?
May I have proof?
Yes, proceed.
I'd like to first point out that I am about to reveal a legal process for the party being charged and also for myself.
Accept it.
I was in an alley buying potatoes from these men, like a thin after the deal, found a fist in my face. When I came to, they were gone and my money and potatoes were gone.
So you were trying to say that you were involved in this deal, but then you got robbed afterwards?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, that is all. Is there another person who would like to speak?
May I speak, Your Honor?
Of course you may.
Thank you, ma'am. I was minding my own business of picking up loose coins from the ground to be able to pay for my next meal. And suddenly, I turned away to find coins on the other side of the tracks. When I came back, I found that all of my coins were gone and my secret stash reeked of potatoes.
You stooped so low as to rob from a hobo? They have rights too.
See, we weren't quite sure that part, so we went with it. We are not proud of it, Your Honor.
Poe, are you done talking?
Yes, ma'am, thank you.
Xavier O'Sullivan and Sebastian Lynch, you're sentenced to 60 months in federal prison with a bail of $3,500. Would you like to say any last words?
I would just like to say that we're both very sorry for our actions, and we know that nothing we say or do can make right what we've done. I think that we can both promise not to resort back to a life of crime after our sentence. Right, CBS?
Right, X.
Officer Larry Dole, take these boys out.
Roger that.
So I guess that it was my decision on my father's innocence or not. That daydream really reminded me of everything that my father had told me throughout the years. How he lost his mother at a young age. And about the